box elders growing along this fence, I hinge cut them.
Right here, all this is going to grow branches, the whole thing. I'm just going to shade this fence a little bit. They're located all along the fence right here. Kind of an experiment there. I topped this Liberty apple tree. I don't like the apple. It's prone to a lot of pests. So now what it's going to become is a shoot generator that I can cut the shoots and use them for smoking salmon.
Pruned out the hazelnuts. These are the old shoots that I took. A couple days worth of firewood there with the new wood burner I have. Look at these blackberry leaves. They're still green even after all that. You know, there's even some minus 0 degree temperatures. It's just amazing. I don't know if they're adapting or they just can do it. I cut some of the limbs off of the honey locust here. This one's got a nice fork in it. Figure something out with that. But you can see it was splitting. There were two limbs coming out of that one spot there and it started to split. I'm gonna wait till this other one leafs out. I'm gonna take that too. And I'll use the leaves for a barrel of ferment. And that'll be pollarded. I think I'll cut it right there. And that'll be a pollard. I'll just keep it pollarded. Generate sticks for fires and whatever. You know, after 2 years, I think they'll grow this thick. And that's even more than just sticks. That's firewood, pole wood. Or like this one's got that nice fork. I'll figure out somewhere to use it. TP trellis. Here's another apple tree that I didn't like. It also is going to be generating sticks for smoking salmon. I did leave part of it go. I didn't like the apples that much, but we'll give it one more year to find out if I would like them or not. Probably not. And I'll cut the other side of this thing too. Cut another limb off of this honey locust that's above me. That's a stout pole. Came off of right there. I cut one last winter. I cut one this winter. There's three more to go. Three more winters to go. Want a big pollard head on top of that too. Generate me more firewood. Here's a comparison between a honey locust and a black locust pole. Which is which? Alright, I'll tell you. The darker one is the honey locust. Here's the honey locust that I topped. I want to do another pollard here. And I topped this Turkish hazelnut to find out if it'll pollard or not. And we'll see. Get the strange bark. It's really soft too. Yeah. I've got three of them on to the left of me. But as well as learning to find out if Turkish hazelnuts were pollard, this is a grafted mulberry. And it was getting shaded pretty densely from both of these two trees. Now it's going to get a chance to get sunlight. That is a martin house that I had put up here and the squirrels destroyed. I mean, the squirrels did that, they just destroyed it. and thrown away. Pawpaw tree. I did a little trimming on the bottom and I topped it. I don't know what's going to happen. I just wanted to top it. See if it'll generate more fruit or less fruit or whatever. Maybe it'll kill it. I don't know. But it's sending up new shoots. Here's one here and here's one here. I already dug out a couple of them and planted them up north and they're still alive. Maybe topping it will stimulate it to put a whole bunch of shoots out here and I'll dig them all up and bring them up north. That right there is a big leaf linden. I pollarded it. I think this is going to send up a lot of shoots. It's about my height, so it's 6 feet high. I'm not quite 6 feet, so it's a little bit higher than me. A little bit taller, a little bit longer. Use whatever description you want. Of course, look at all the nice pole wood there. I mean, that's good firewood there and there. If I laid them all down, I think the deer and the rabbits will eat the buds. It's a food source. So I topped this redbud tree, not all of them, just some of the shoots here. There's two here and there's one there. And the three in the background I left grow. Background meaning on the shade side. Sun is shining down this way. Here's a silver linden that I topped. I pollarded. We'll have a lot of pollards back here to generate firewood. And it's above everything, so the shoots will be sent out pretty fast and provide shade for the ground as they're growing. At least that's my idea. The black walnut shoots that I'm cutting on 2 year cycles. And this is the third cycle that I cut. And it's some pretty thick limwood here for 2 years. With that new wood burner, that might be a week's worth of burning. This is all the limwood from that tree here that fell down. You can see it in the background. I cut it up until that point because that's the border of my land here. But either this can be used as brush piles for the wildlife, which, you know, I got this registered with the World Wildlife Fund and that's one of the things that they require, or maybe they encourage, I'm not sure. And also I can use it as stick wood to start fires and wood burner. And here's all the larger pieces. This tree's been dead for years, so I don't have to worry about drying. I can chuck it right in. Burned it up. And here are the two heads from the pollarded black walnuts. They're forming up quite nicely. I was going to cut that last limb up, but I thought, well, it's below the head, so maybe we'll let it grow. Last year, it formed three nuts on this branch, so maybe it'll make some nuts. And then that has a certain configuration, representing a certain kind of a symbol. You'll have to figure it out for yourself though. And I cut back some of these honeyberry shoots here, the older ones. I didn't even pull them out of here yet. There's one right here. You can see where I cut it off right there. That was an old one. I think I did two, maybe three of them. Here's another one. Oh, there's the other one. Ooh, it's caught up in this one. So it opened this up pretty nice. I could do one more here. No, we'll just, I'm not going to do too much at once. I'll do some more next year. There's a couple of them in here that I cut. Getting roughed up. That'll stimulate them. Ooh, I'm gonna cut three of mine in this one too. That's a nice looking one right here. Yeah, this one really needs to get out of there. There, look at how nice and open it looks now. I could probably do a couple more, but I'm not gonna. Should get a pole and stand that up. That one I only took two out of. This one was always a legger. It's just starting to come on. These are old honeyberries. Like I said in another video, I was thinking they're 12 years old. But maybe they're older because they're, how old were they in the pot when I bought them? Because they were pretty big in the pot. These might be, it might have been 15 years old. They might be 15 years old now. Looks good. It's warmer today, but I don't have a jacket on, so that's it. I'm to the end of my warmth limit. I gotta spend more time outside because I'm gonna get used to going fishing, ice fishing. And all these branches came from pollarding this mulberry. I don't like the berries, and I decided to turn it into a pollard to generate sticks for the wood burner. And now these crab apples and apples, and there's hazelnut in there, and aronia, and cherry, and pea shrubs. All those are gonna get more sunlight. I think that's a pear. It's a pear tree here. There's another nice pull from that mulberry. A couple of them, that one too. That'll be a night or two in the wood burner. I have more pruning ideas, but I have to think about them a little more. All these I just showed you were items that I wanted to do this winter for sure. And the rest of it, I gotta think about it. Maybe I'll let them go another year. Other than that, that's it. I'm going in. We're in the darkness, and we're walking out into the light. Everything. My bright, cheery face. And my misshapen yellow teeth. That's okay. The dentist cleaning girl, she says to me something about collagen.
Collagen?
I said, what's collagen for? Oh, she says it stimulates hair growth. Oh, I says, I don't have that problem. She gave me a double take on that one. This device right here is in my basement. There are three functions to it. As you can see, there's an afterburner on the ceiling. Or afterburner, or reburner. burning the exhaust. I've got it on its lowest air intake setting now, so I'm gonna open it up. This burner gives off the heat in a massive way. It's the largest firebox that they had. They could put big pieces in here. Look at that. Turn it back down. Get reburned. Now it has protective side panels here, but it's the top that gets very hot. There's an airflow mechanism here. It comes in from the bottom and it sucks up through the back, through here. There's a blower, but I'm not going to turn the blower on because this is our first couple of burns. And the paint has to cure. I don't want to smell it. And it's paired with the most fuel efficient natural gas furnace that I could find, that I could buy. And then, and if you didn't think I could have any more, I have this solar air heater inside of the house. And it's blowing hot on this sunny, cold day. Makes a lot of sense because the coldest days are sunny. To have a solar air panel. How can I afford all these things? Some people are going to say, well, you know, and I don't go on vacations or cruises, or I don't smoke, don't drink, don't go out to eat. I'd rather plan for the future.
Another workout. I needed that. I sat on my rear end for the last couple weeks, hiding in the cold. Ah! Oh.